Welcome back to News Nation. AT&T is doing some serious damage control after Consumer Reports' latest survey ranks it the worst cell phone carrier in the country on its website. Joining us. So AT&T is responding to Consumer Reports saying that it's at the bottom.
Well, it's saying that
blogs dedicated to the speculation that Verizon will get the iPhone. This is not a done deal. But some believe it is certainly possible by the beginning of next year.
It's at least
people involved in any of this negotiating between AT&T and Verizon. What role, I should say? Of course, they're involved in it, but what role would they play? Thank you, Dan. Greatly appreciate it. It'll be interesting to see what happens. Well, the world remembers John Lennon today, the 30th anniversary of his death. Rolling Stone is releasing its last print interview, and we're also hearing parts of an interview that John Lennon did just hours before his death. TodayShow.com's pop culture columnist Courtney Hazlett is here with me. Courtney.
Hi, Tamara. Yes, it is a really fascinating story. A journalist from Rolling Stone, Jonathan Cott, conducting an interview with John Lennon just 3 days before he died. That interview resulted in more than 9 hours of audio tape, some of which he didn't transcribe until earlier this year when he came across the tapes again. Of course, Rolling Stone did release part of his interviews right after his death, but like I said, they just didn't transcribe every word of it. Really eerie things came out of that interview, such as insight John Lennon had into people only wanting to see him on the way up and not on the way back down or doing something that didn't exactly. We keep reflecting on him as he really was at a crossroads of fame. He was the type of person who we hadn't really seen fame and pop culture intersect exactly like it did for the Beatles and then definitely with John Lennon, who seemed to predict his fame or his death slightly because of his fame. There's another interview that came out from Dave Sholin. He's a radio journalist, and he interviewed Lennon just 3 hours before his death. Take a listen to some of that. It's eerie to hear him in his own voice saying that. He doesn't want to have to sell his soul again to have another hit record. And I think it's a conundrum that so many people at the very top of their game face, you know, not to equate the two.
And read so much, and then there are new things to hear and read about John Lennon.
Exactly.
Very interesting. Thank you for the latest. Thank you, Courtney. For the latest entertainment news, log on to scoop.todayshow.com. Boss loses his job at the mall after saying this.